Hello students, good afternoon and a very happy new year to you all. How are you? Hope you all are enjoying your academics as well as non-academics, right? I am Rajesh Dadij, your mentor in English from Shivjyoti Educational Group, Kota. So today we are going to discuss your next chapter, chapter 5, or short stories number 5. In your book Woven Words, right? And that chapter is Papachi's Moth, right? And this chapter was written by Arundhati Roy, one of the great writers, social activist, novelist, etc., etc., right? So about the poet, about the writer Arundhati Roy, we'll come to know later, but before that, we are going to discuss the title of the chapter, Papachi's Moth. Papachi is the main character of this chapter, who is too much frustrated in his life, right? He has so much frustration in his mind regarding his career, regarding his social life, regarding his personal life, right? So he is the main protagonist of this chapter. Moth. Moth is a kind of insect. Moth is a kind of insect that looks like a butterfly. It is not a butterfly. It is not a species of a butterfly, but still it looks like the species of butterfly. That's why it has been mentioned here, or we may say the title is quite apt. Papachi's Moth means Papachi discovered this moth, but this moth itself became his frustration, and ultimately this person dies in the end, right? We'll come to know of it also during this chapter, right students? So this is the title of this chapter. Mamachi has started making pickles. Let me tell you, before we start this chapter, first of all, let me summarize this chapter so that it will become easier for you to understand in a better way, right? The main protagonist is Papachi, and the second main character is Mamachi. Papachi and Mamachi, they both are husband and wife, okay students? And they have two children, Amu and Chako, right students? Chako goes abroad for further studies. Okay, we come to know that this person Papachi is too much frustrated in his life. He bears so much frustration. That's why out of his frustration, he keeps beating his wife Mamachi almost every day, or we may say almost every night. And this is not only an ordinary beating, but he uses a brass metal, means a flower vase made of brass, he uses to beat Mamachi, his wife, because he is jealous. He envies her name and fame. Though Papachi also has got too much name and fame as the director of a great institute of India, the Pusa Institute of Technology, Delhi. Okay, students. So he retired from this post, right? So the whole story weaves around this title, Papachi's Moth. So have a look. Mamachi, Papachi's wife, has started making pickles commercially soon after Papachi retired from government service in Delhi. Delhi means that I told you he retired from the post of director to the institute, Pusa Institute of Technology, Delhi, right? Earlier, before being the director, means later he was promoted to the post of director, but earlier he was a scientist in the same institute, right students? So, and came to live in MNN, the Kottayam, the Bible Society was having an affair and asked Mamachi, means after his retirement, he and his wife got shifted to MNN, right students? And over there in this place, at this place, there was a society named Kottayam Bible Society, and once the people of the society came to know of Mamachi's talent of making pickles, so they gave order to Mamachi to prepare some pickle for a fair, right? And Mamachi did so and asked Mamachi to make some of a famous banana jam and tender mango pickle. She did that. It sold quickly and Mamachi found that she had more orders than she could cope with. She could not manage all these things because she had not expected this much of success, right? So, it sold quickly. Thrilled, she was too much excited, she was too much thrilled with her success. She decided to persist with the, she decided to continue with the pickles and jam and soon found herself busy all year round. Now, she had got success after success and in this way, she became a very successful and talented pickle maker, right? Jam maker and pickle maker. Papachi, for his part, was having trouble coping with the ignominy of retirement. Means he was not happy because of his retirement. Though it was compulsory retirement, but still he was not happy. And this we'll come to know later in this chapter. Right, students? He had frustration and was having trouble coping with. He was not able to cope with, bear the ignominy of the retirement. He was 17 years older than Mamachi. This is also one of the causes of frustration in his mind. Dear students, over and again I am using, Papachi had frustration, Papachi had inferiority complex, Papachi was a sort of violent person, violent character in this chapter. He was too much aggressive. From the very beginning we have been given his introduction or given his character. Why? So many reasons are there. One of the reasons is, you can see here, he was 17 years older than Mamachi. So obviously, he was 17 years older than Mamachi. What does it mean? It means he was growing a little bit older, but Mamachi was not, because she was 17 years younger. So she was not looking older and he was looking older. So he was not looking as smart as she was looking. So this is one reason. Second reason, after his retirement, he remained idle. He had nothing to do during the whole time, but kept sitting at his place in the garden on a particular chair made of mahogany wood. Right, students? But he had none to share his retirement. So he expected his wife's presence during his retirement, but she was not available because she was getting orders after orders for jams and pickles. So she remained busy. Mamachi expected his presence. Mamachi, on the other hand, she expected that her husband after retirement would support her in the pickle making business, and in this way he would also keep himself busy. But nothing like that happened and things went worse and worse, and in this way he started beating more violently to his wife. Right, students? And realized with a shock that he was an old man when his wife was still in her prime. She was not looking as old as he was. Though Mamachi had conical corneas, this is a kind of eye disease, students, cornea, right? So she had some problems in her cornea and was already practically blind. She was not able to see anything properly. Papachi would not help her with the pickle making. Pickle making means buying mangoes and raw material from the market, cutting up mangoes, raw mangoes, and then spices to be sorted out, to be ground properly, and these chopped mangoes were to be dried up in the sun. So everything had to be done by Mamachi only, and Papachi was nowhere to help her. Right, students? So he did not help her in the pickle making because he did not consider pickle making a suitable job for a high ranking ex-government official. Despite his retirement, he himself behaved as if he was an officer, high ranking official. That's why he kept on wearing his 3-piece suit, gold chain, and some more things were there. They reflected his being a higher class person, right? Despite his retirement. So he thought that I am an ex-official government person. So my wife is preparing pickles. It just goes beyond my dignity in this way, right, students? He had always been a jealous man, so he greatly resented the attention his wife was certainly getting. He slouched around the compound in his immaculately tailored suits, weaving swollen circles around mounds of red chilies and freshly powdered yellow turmeric. These are spices, students. They were lying over there on the ground in heap and watching Mamachi supervise the buying, the weighing, the salting and drying. All these are things that are, and from now and then he kept moving here and there around her when she was preparing, when she was undergoing all these tasks of preparing pickles and gems of limes and tender mangoes, right, raw mangoes, right. Every night he bat her with a brass flower vase. The beatings were not new. Means Mamachi was also now used to that beating, and this kind of behavioral attitude she was receiving from her husband, now she was also used to that, right. What was new was only the frequency with which they took place. Means she was used to beating, but now they were frequently taking place. Means now she was frequently beaten up, so that was new to her. Otherwise rest of all things were just same, and she was already used to all those things. One night Papachi broke the bow of Mamachi's violin and threw it in the river. Means earlier when he was getting training, when he was getting training, means when he was getting education in technology in Vienna. So his wife was there and she was learning violin. She was learning violin, right, instrumental. So one day he came to know from her teacher, from her instructor, that she was really talented. She was really a talented violinist and she had very bright future. So Mamachi got first fame and name through her instructor, and Papachi could not bear with it, and then he grew angry, and at that same moment he broke that violin then and there and threw it in the river flowing nearby. In this way we come to know that he was not of good temper, but he was of a bad temper, right. Then Chaco came home for a summer vacation from Oxford. I told you in the beginning, Chaco, their son, he was abroad. He was means at Oxford University for further education, but during summer vacation when he came home, he saw his father beating his mother. He grew angry. He could not bear up. So he had grown to be a big man, and what now means this Chaco had grown, means he had become mature, obviously big man, and was in those days strong from rowing for Balliol. A week after he arrived, he found Papachi beating Mamachi in the study. In the mini library of their own, he found his father beating his mother. He could not tolerate it. He could not put up with his father in this way, and Chaco strode into the room, burst into the rooms and caught Papachi's vast hand and twisted it around his back. In this way he twisted his father's hand and warned him not to beat his mother in future, otherwise he would be worse person. I never want this to happen again, he told his father, ever. Means I don't want you to beat my mother ever again in future. Mind these words, he warned his father. For the rest of that day, Papachi sat in the veranda and stared stonily out at the ornamental ground. He was too much disturbed. Means after this incident, Papachi got too much disturbed. He had never expected his son behaving like this, so he got too much disturbed. The next day, he kept sitting in the garden and ignoring the plates of food that Cochu Maria brought him. He did not feel like taking meals also. That's why he ignored. Late at night, he went into his study and brought out his favorite mahogany rocking chair. He had a very much favorite chair in which he used to sit during his relaxed moments. So that same night, he went into his study, means mini library and he broke that chair. He put it down in the middle of the driveway and smashed it into little bits with a plumber's monkey wrench. In this way, he got too much disturbed that he broke his favorite chair also, right? He left it there in the moonlight, a heap of varnished wicker and splintered wood. And in this way, he got it burnt. He never touched Mamachi again. This was a great change. He had stopped because of the warning given to him by his son. He had stopped. But one big change was there. He not only stopped beating his wife, but he stopped talking to his wife also. Right, students? So, he never talked, but he never spoke to her either as long as he lived. Thereafter, throughout his lifetime, he never talked to his wife. Right, students? When he needed anything, he used Kochumaria or baby Kochamma as intermediaries. He means whenever he wanted anything, he required anything, he used these two people for those things, but he never felt like talking to his wife because he had felt humiliated at the hands of his own son Chaku. In the evenings, when he knew visitors were expected, he would sit on the veranda and sew buttons that weren't missing onto his shirts. Actually, buttons were already there, but he pretended as if he was sewing buttons on his shirt just to show that his wife Mamachi was not taking better care of him after his retirement. Means he wanted to just humiliate her in the presence of public, right? So, to create the impression that Mamachi neglected him to some small degree, he did succeed in further corroding MNM's views of working wives. Means in this way, he was just putting all the working women's prestige at stake indirectly. He was of the opinion that as soon as the women, such kind of women, start working for their own household, means they start earning, we can say, so their attitude, their behavioral attitude to their family members just change, right? He bought the sky blue Plymouth from an old Englishman in Mannar. This chapter is on the background of Kerala, and Mannar is also in Kerala. Okay, students. So he purchased a Plymouth, means a car, a unique car was there, old car was there, right? And we may call it a vintage car. Okay, so he purchased, but he was so much frustrated that he never allowed anyone to use that car. He became a familiar sight in M&M, casting importantly down the narrow road in his white car, looking outwardly elegant but sweating freely inside the woolen suit. Despite summer vacation, despite summer season, he kept on putting this woolen suit in three-piece just to show off, right? He was flaunting. He would not allow Mamachi or anyone else in the family to use it. It means this car, or even to sit in it. The Plymouth was Papachi's revenge. Actually, he was using this car just to take revenge upon all other family members who were on the side of Mamachi, right? Papachi had been an imperial entomologist. Entomologists are the people who study science of moths, science of insects, myths and mites, right, students? So at the Pusa Institute, after independence, when the British left, his designation was changed from imperial entomologist after this Indian independence. The year he retired, he had risen to a rank equivalent to director. Thereafter, once again he was promoted and full-fledged director, he became of the same institute. His life's greatest setback was not having had the moth that he had discovered named after him. This is the basic reason, this is the main reason why he was resented, why he showed his resentment. Actually, once he was consuming liquor Okay, at a public place, and all of a sudden he observed a moth like creature or insect in his wine glass. So he took it out and caught it, and next day he got it dried up in the sunlight so that the liquor, ethanol, got evaporated. Right, student? So he found it quite different. So he made so much research, and after some time he came to a conclusion that it was a unique creature, a unique moth, and he told his seniors about this moth as his new discovery. But to his utter amazement, he was not given credit, but he was told that this was just one of the common creatures. But the thing is, after this incident, means 12 years after this incident, what happened? You know, the same moth had been shown as a new discovery, but it was not named after its original discoverer, Apache, but somebody else who was now the director of that institute was given the credit. This is also one of the reasons of his resentment. Okay, students? His life setback was, okay, it fell into his drink. It means this moth fell into his drink one evening while he was sitting in the veranda of a rest house after a long day in the field. As he picked it out, he noticed its unusually dense dorsal tufts. He took a closer look. With growing excitement, he mounted it, measured it, and the next morning placed it in the sun for a few hours for the alcohol to evaporate. Then he caught the first train back to Delhi. To taxonomic attention and he hoped fame. He thought that he would be given credit, but after 6 unbearable months of anxiety, to Papachi's intense disappointment, he was told that his moth, so-called moth he had discovered, had finally been identified as a slightly unusual face of a well-known species that belonged to the tropical family. And what was that species? And that was Limantride, right? The real blow came 12 years later when, as a consequence of a radical taxonomic reshuffle. Okay, student, lepidopterists are the people who are studying different species of butterflies. Okay, lepidopterists decided that Papachi's moth was in fact a separate species, and it was decided that that was really a separate species, and genus hitherto unknown to science. That was really a new discovery. By then, of course, Papachi had retired and moved to M&M. It was too late for him to assert his claim to the discovery. His moth was named after the acting director of the Department of Entomology, a junior officer whom, at the time when Papachi was in job, this person, junior, he was just a junior officer under him, right? But now he had become director and he had been given this credit of this discovery, whom Papachi had always disliked. Papachi never liked this junior officer. In the years to come, even though he had been ill-humored long before he discovered the moth, Papachi's moth was held responsible for his black moods, means swollen moods, means bad temper, right? And sudden bouts of temper, means he used to get fits of anger. The pernicious ghost, gray, furry, and with unusually dense dorsal tufts, haunted every house that he ever lived in. He is just saying through these lines that this moth himself was the cause of all this. This moth tormented him and his children and his children's children, means his grandchildren, right? Until the day he died, means the day when he died of heart attack, right? Even in the shifting M&M heat every single day, Papachi wore a single pressed three-piece suit and his gold pocket watch on his dressing table. Next to his cologne, he had his favorite perfume also, and silver hair brush was also there. He kept a picture of himself as a young man when he was getting education in Vienna, right? With his hair slicked down, at the time he was quite young, taken in a photographer's studio in a Vienna in Vienna, where he had done the 6-month diploma course that he had qualified him to apply for the post of imperial entomologist. Right, so at the time he was getting training, and it was during those few months they spent in Vienna that Mamachi took her first lessons on the violin. As we have already discussed, right, the lessons were abruptly discontinued. All of a sudden those lessons, means her violin classes, were disturbed because of Papachi's interference. Discontinued when Mamachi's teacher Longsky Tafnethal made the mistake of telling Papachi that his wife was exceptionally talented. This the author has satirically used this term, that she had made a mistake, right, and in his opinion potentially concert classes. Mamachi pasted in the family photograph album the clipping from the Indian Express that reported Papachi's death. On the other hand, now let's come back to our current scene. When Papachi died of heart attack, and this news was published in the newspaper, so this Mamachi was so much attached to Papachi. Actually, this doesn't mean that she really loved her husband. She never loved her husband because of his bad temper throughout his lifetime, but actually she was now used to all these things. Means whenever she was preparing pickle, he was moving around, so his presence, she had become used to his presence. And secondly, she used to be beaten almost every night, so she was used to that also. Now she was missing, that's why she started crying bitterly, noted entomologist. This is the cutting of the newspaper, right, noted entomologist Sri Bannon John Ipe. Bannon John Ipe is the real name of Papachi, son of late Reverend E. John Ipe of M&M, popularly known as Panyan Kanju, suffered a massive heart attack and passed away at the Kottayam. Kottayam is one of the districts of Kerala General Hospital last night. He developed chest pains around, this is just a news of his death, okay, and was rushed to hospital. He was taken to hospital. The end came at 2:45. He breathed his light at 2:45 a.m. Sri Ipe, means this John Ipe, had been keeping in different health since last 6 months. He is supervised by his wife Soshamma and 2 children. Okay students, Soshamma means Mamachi and her 2 children, and they are Amu, and one more is there, we have already discussed about him. Just think over it. I am not telling you this name because we have already come to know that that child gave his father warning not to touch his mother again. So, right students, at Papachi's funeral, Mamachi cried and her contact lenses slid around in her eyes. She wept so bitterly that contact lenses in her eyes got disturbed. Amu, one of the twins, Amu told the twins, means Amu and Chaku. I'm telling you the another name, right? Amu and Chaku. These are 2 twins, right? So Amu told the twins that Mamachi was crying more because she was used to him than because she loved him. She did not love him as much as we come to know, but she was used to all his bad tempers. Because she was used to him than because she loved him. She was used to having him slouching around the pickle factory. Slouching around means moving around, moving about, just to inspect, as if he were inspecting each and everything, as if he were supervising each and everything, right? And was used to being beaten from time to time. Amu said that human beings were creatures of habit, and it was amazing the kind of things they could get used to. You only had to look around you, Amu said. Amu made this statement to see that beatings with brass vases were the least of them. Right student, Arundhati Roy, an architect by training, is a novelist and screenwriter. Her first novel, The God of Small Things, from which this extract has been selected, is the winner of the 1997 Booker Prize, a prestigious literary award. She now lives in New Delhi as an activist and a member of Human Rights Association. So dear students, I hope you might have got this chapter, and each and everything must be clear to you. Though this whole chapter is full of so many characters, interwoven together, but still I have just tried to explain each and everything, but still if you come across any kind of doubts, just feel at home, feel relaxed, and you may share your doubts with us during your live session. Have a nice time. See you some other day with the next topic. Have a nice day. Thank you.